to do a little task. Normally we do this as group work, but now please think about them by yourself. So think about like being a computer, and you get this little program that is here printed on the left. On the right hand side, you have to put for each of this step, the state of it, what is the value. And if you don't know what it is, which means it's undefined, you put a question mark. So basically we would start here in the first line, and then we would figure out what would be the number for num1, num2, and sum. So what's the number for num1 here? Is this known or is it undefined? And now you proceed to the second line, and then you put again into these three memory cells here the value, and so on in the third line and the fourth line, where we actually do some assignments. So what will be the result? Please do so now and fill a little table. So the result is that in this case, as long as we are in a declaration block, all the values are basically undefined here. Finally here in this line, we assign the number 2 to num2, so we put here 2, num2, and sum are still undefined. Num2 becomes assigned value 5, but at this point, what is num1? Well, it's still 2, right? Because that's what we did before. So we put here the 2, and here we have 5, here's a question mark. Finally, we have to do the assignment here, which means when we do this assignment operator, sum becomes num1 plus num2. What is the result? Well, we look here in the table before, num1 was 2, num2 was 5, so the result is now 7, that gets assigned to sum. So this kind of tasks are very typical when you try to understand and you are a beginner, so you must comprehend them and do them very thoroughly, otherwise you will struggle in the future. So try to follow it and recapitulate until you understand. So here is now a little more complicated program, and the question is, what does it do? Right, first we have to understand the different blocks. We see we have a declaration block followed by a statement block here, and in the declaration block we have a number which is an integer, we have a letter which is a character, and we have a floating point number. We do a little bit of assignment, think about what it does for a moment. What does this output? Right, it takes num, but what is num? Well, let's go back. Num initially was 12. Well, we num became whatever num was, which was 12 plus 5 makes it 17. So it should put 17. We put letter is A, so we print A. And by the way, the format specifier for a character is %C. And here we print the floating point number. The format type is %F. What is the floating point number? 12.34. Well, that's exactly what we output here. We in fact will output a few more digits, because that's the way this format will work. I'm not executing this now for you. I think you can do that using the time while you watch this video.